All Little Red Riding Hood had to do was to get on her way with the basket under her arm. Granny lived in a little house in a clearing a little way into the woods. The path was well worn because Little Red Riding Hood had traveled it nearly every day since she'd been old enough to make her way on her own. It usually took just over a half an hour to walk all the way to Granny's house. The sun filtered through the treetops and shone on a little bridge over a babbling brook, and Little Red Riding Hood stopped and watched the fish jumping and catching flies as they buzzed just above the water's surface. I can't just stand here and have a rest. I've got to hurry to Granny's so that she gets her medicine. Just as she came to the last stretch over the bridge, a black cloud covered the sun. It became dark, as though it was late in the evening, even though it was early morning. The birds that had been singing and twittering in the trees fell silent, and all that you could hear was the gentle splashing of the winding stream. How weird, especially when I'm so afraid of the dark. She could hardly make out the path anymore. And if I can't follow it, I'll get lost, and then I won't be able to find my way to Granny's or home again. She put the basket down on the bridge, pulled her cardigan around her, and peered out into the darkness. Suddenly, two thin, bright slits appeared between the fir trees a few meters away.
Help! What is that?
It looks sort of like a dog. The eyes came closer, and now she could hear panting.